In this lecture, we will understand three concepts related to programming, that is identifiers, constants, and keywords. Identifiers. The variable names are also known as identifiers. Names of variables, functions, labels, and various other user-defined data types such as classes, arrays, structures, unions, etc. They are called identifiers. Identifiers can vary from 1 to several characters. There are certain rules on how to create an identifier. The first character must be a letter or an underscore, and the subsequent characters can be letters, digits, or underscores. So, an identifier is a combination of letters, digits, and underscores. First character can be a letter or an underscore, and the subsequent characters can be any combination of letters, digits, or underscores. So here are some correct and incorrect identifier names. Count is correct. Test 2-3 is correct. High underscore balance is correct. One count is incorrect. Why? Because the first character is a digit. This is not allowed. This is also incorrect because exclamation mark is not allowed. High dot 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 balance, this is also not allowed. Dot is not allowed. In C++, there is no limit to the length of an identifier, but at least first 1024 characters are significant. In an identifier, uppercase and lowercase letters are distinct. For example, this count, and this count, they are separate identifiers. An identifier cannot be the same as a C or C++ keyword and should not have the same name as functions that are in the C or C++ library. For example, if I create an identifier int char equal to 25. This is the data type, this is the identifier name, and this is the value. This identifier name is same as the keyword char. This is not allowed. Similarly, if I write int cout equal to 25, this is also not allowed. Now we come to constants. Constants are the fixed values that the program may not alter. Constants can be any of the basic data types like int, float, double, char, etc. The way each constant is represented depending on its type. For example, an int constant will contain integers. A double constant will contain floating point numbers. A character constant will be stored inside single inverted commas. A string constant will be stored inside double inverted commas. Constants are also known as literals. Character constants are enclosed between single quotes. We already know this. For example, A and this percentage sign, they are the character constants. In order to specify a wide character constant, we precede the character with an L. Wide character constant is also a primitive data type. Normal character data type can store 256 values, 256 characters, but the wide character data type can represent 2^16 characters. So it has more expressive power. The keyword which we use for a wide character is wchar_t, and here the identifier is wc, and then we are specifying a value wc equal to l. L means this is a wide character constant, and inside the single quotes we specify the character which this WC will store. Here WC is assigned the white character constant equivalent of A. Integer constants are specified as numbers without any fractional components. For example, 10 minus 100. Floating point constants require decimal point followed by the number of numbers fractional component. For example, 11.123. So here we have some data types and constant examples. Int 1, 123, 21,000, minus 234, long int. Long int, whenever you specify a long int, you have to put a capital L at the end. Unsigned int. Unsigned int has to be represented by a capital U at the end. Float, you have to put capital F at the end. Double, long double, again capital L. Floating point constants are assumed to be doubles by default. But if you follow a floating point constant with an F, the number is treated as float. If you just write float F equal to 2.5, it will be treated as a double. It will be treated as a double. If you want this number to be treated as a float, you have to put an F at the end. Only then it will be treated as a float. If you follow it with an L, the number will become long double. So here we put L, now it will become a long double. By default, if I just write long double LB equal to 1001.2, it will be treated as a double. If I want it to be treated as a long double, I have to put L at the end. For integer types, the U suffix stands for unsigned and L for long. Now, hexadecimal and octal constants. You might be knowing about the hexadecimal and octal number system. The number system based on 8 is called octal. It uses the digits through 0 to 7. And the 16 base number system is called hexadecimal system, which uses the digits 0 through 9 plus the letters A through F, which stands for 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15 respectively. A hexadecimal constant must consist of a 0x followed by the constant in hexadecimal form. An octal constant begins with O. For example, int hex, int is the data type, hex is its name or the identifier, and 0x specifies that this is not decimal, this is hexadecimal, and then we specify it in the hexadecimal form 80. In decimal it will become 128. Similarly, in order to declare a octal constant, we write int oct equal to 012. Here 0 specifies that this is an octal constant. 12 is its value. 12 means 10 in decimal. Now, string constants. A string is a set of characters which is enclosed in double quotes. For example, this is a test. Inside the double quotes is a string. A few characters such as carriage return are impossible to enter in a string from the keyword. For example, if you want to write hello world and then in the next line you want to write how are you, then how will you write it? This is possible with the help of backslash character constants or the escape sequences. So in this example, we are using two escape sequences or two backslash character constants, backslash n, backslash t. Backslash n stands for new line, and backslash t stands for a tap. Okay, so when we are going to execute this program, backslash n means the cursor will move to the new line, and backslash t means it will move to the next tab, and then it will print this is a test. You can try to run this program. This table lists the backslash character constants which are available in the C++ language. For example, backslash b for backspace, backslash f for form field, backslash n for new line, backslash r, backslash t, double quotes, single quotes, null, backslash, vertical tab, alert, question mark, octal constants, hexadecimal constants. Then we move on to keywords. Keywords are those words whose meaning is already defined by the compiler. For example, auto, bool, break, continue, if, else, main, case, double, public, etc. You are familiar with many of these. For example, bool, main, double. Okay. We also know many other keywords like int, char, float, short, long, signed, unsigned, etc. We will encounter many more keywords as we go along this course. These keywords cannot be used as an identifier. This thing we already discussed in the previous slides. In other words, we can say that keywords are the collection of reserved words and predefined identifiers. So, two things are known as keywords, the reserved words and the predefined identifiers. These auto, bool, break, continue, if, else, these are the reserved words. Main is a predefined identifier. Predefined identifier means the identifier that is already defined by the compiler. The main is the name of the function. Okay, main is the name of the function, and this name is already defined by the compiler, but we can change its meaning. Okay, so this is a predefined identifier. So you can declare a variable called main inside your main function. You can initialize it and you can also print out its value. You can try this on your own. But you cannot do the same with a variable name else. You can create int main equal to 33. This is valid, but you cannot do int else equal to 33. This is not valid because else is a reserved word, while main is a predefined identifier, but both of them are keywords. Both of them are keywords. Okay. The difference is that else is a reserved word, while main is only a predefined identifier.